Apple recently held one of their most densely packed worldwide developer conferences ever, where they announced some pretty incredible technology, like Sidecar in macOS Catalina, Dark Mode in iOS 13, Project Catalyst, SwiftUI, and even a new Mac Pro. But despite all these exciting announcements, the product that received the most publicity was a display stand. And that's because Apple decided to create a $5,000 display while selling its stand separately for an extra $1,000. And you can actually hear the audience's reaction to this news.
The Visa mount adapter will be $199 and the Pro stand $999. And like the Mac Pro, they'll all be available in the fall. So that is the new Mac Pro and Pro Display XDR. Now back to Tim.
Now, I'm not making this video to defend Apple or justify the stand's price. We're simply going to explore reasons why Apple is selling their display stand separately and why it might be so expensive. This is Greg with Apple Explained, and I want to thank Squarespace for sponsoring this video. If you want to help decide which topics I cover, make sure you're subscribed, and these voting polls will show up in your mobile activity feed. Now, in order to put Apple's new Pro Display XDR in perspective, we have to become familiar with the sort of displays Apple has released in the past, the most recent model being the Thunderbolt display in 2011, which sold for $1,000. It was marketed to everyday consumers who wanted a more streamlined external display solution. It featured a built-in FaceTime HD camera, a microphone, speakers, and an array of I/O ports. But when it came to the panel quality, there wasn't much to set it apart from its competition. With a 1,000:1 contrast ratio, 375 nits of brightness, and a resolution of 2560 by 1440, the Thunderbolt display delivered a typical viewing experience. Apple continued to sell the display until 2016, when they decided to exit the display market altogether, saying, "There are a number of great third-party options available for Mac users." Now, I actually thought this was the right decision for Apple, since their display panels weren't much better than average. In fact, I'd say there was only two advantages of owning an Apple display. First was their signature Apple design, and second, they worked seamlessly with your Mac. But those benefits weren't enough to justify the Thunderbolt display's premium cost. Because although its $1,000 price tag may not sound too bad by today's standards, you could easily find third-party monitors with comparable panels for half that price. And although Apple stopped making their own external monitors, they did partner with LG to create the ultra-fine 4K and 5K displays in 2016, which were designed to be used with MacBooks and featured the same high-quality panels as the Retina iMacs. So it appeared that the days of Apple-designed displays were over. That is, until 2017, when rumors surrounding a new high-end 6K Apple display began to surface. It came as a surprise to many, considering Apple had just announced their departure from the display industry 1 year earlier. Now, that rumor became a reality at this year's WWDC when Apple revealed the Pro Display XDR, which introduced features that had never been seen before on displays in its class. It delivers 1,000 nits of sustained brightness, which is far higher than the average 300 to 400 nits. It has a 1,000,000:1 contrast ratio, which is just crazy compared to the average 1,000:1 ratio. And it delivers billions of colors, perfect blacks, and a color-consistent ultra-wide viewing angle. Not to mention its retina-level pixel density of 218 pixels per inch. But what really sets the Pro Display XDR apart from Apple's previous monitors is its starting price of $5,000, a significant jump from the $1,000 Thunderbolt display, which was already considered to be pricey. But there's a huge distinction that needs to be made when comparing the Pro Display XDR to anything else on the market, and that is, Apple isn't marketing this product to the everyday consumer like they had been with their Thunderbolt displays, which is probably why it's the first Apple display to have the word Pro in its name. Just look at the terminology Apple uses on its product page. Transforms the professional workflow. The world's best Pro display. When multiple people review work together on a single screen, it's critical that everyone sees the same thing. If you're in an especially uncontrolled lighting environment, there's an innovative matte option. Professionals require a lot from their displays. It wasn't just made for the pro workflow, it redefines it. So it's clear Apple is using terminology to target a specific demographic of professional customers. Also, we have to consider how the display was introduced. It was featured alongside the new Mac Pro, which obviously is not a machine for everyday users. So it's very important to understand that discrepancy when considering the marketing decisions Apple made. Because if you watch their WWDC, Apple didn't compare the Pro Display XDR to their old Thunderbolt display or even LG's ultrafine displays. They compared it to reference monitors, which cost tens of thousands of dollars and are used in very specific professional settings, like on movie sets or in editing studios. And in that context, Apple's Pro Display XDR will likely disrupt the display market by bringing features that were previously only available on expensive reference monitors to a more reasonably priced display. Now, before we go any further, I want to point out that there are some big differences between broadcast reference monitors and Apple's Pro Display XDR. While we don't know everything about Apple's new display, I think it's safe to assume it won't feature some of the very niche functionality of a $40,000 reference monitor. Things like interlacing options, attaching multiple SDI inputs for multi-camera recording, and allowing for custom marker overlays for different aspect ratios. These advanced features are necessary in many professional settings and likely won't be possible with Apple's Pro Display XDR. So while I don't want to lead you to believe that reference monitors will be replaced, it is true that Apple's new display incorporates many incredible features that pros would definitely find helpful. So now that we understand the context of this product in the pro market, we can begin to unravel the mystery behind its $1,000 stand. You see, most professionals don't use stands with their reference monitors since they already have an existing workstation in place, so they'll simply mount it to whatever setup they already have. That's why Apple is offering a stand and VESA mount separate from the display. It seems like an odd approach to everyday customers, but isn't so strange to high-end professionals, which again is Apple's target market. But I don't think people were upset about the stand being sold separately as much as its $1,000 price, which is exorbitant. Now, Apple kind of tried to justify its cost by demonstrating how many components were inside the hinge and how much technology was required to counterbalance a display to make it feel weightless when adjusted. But the simple fact is this stand is not worth $1,000. It doesn't have the technology or component cost of a $1,000 iPhone XS. It'd even be a stretch for Apple to sell this stand for $500. So the big question is, why is the stand so unnecessarily expensive? Now, Apple hasn't given an official explanation and probably never will, but I think I have a reasonable answer. And it has everything to do with Apple's approach to their accessories business. You see, the term Apple tax has been used throughout the years to describe Apple's tendency to charge more for a product than its competition. And nowhere is this more apparent than with their accessories. For example, Apple's Magic Keyboard costs $130, and if you want the space gray color, there's a $20 upcharge. A comparable HP keyboard costs just $90. And consider their leather sleeves, which cost $30 for the Apple Pencil and $130 for the iPad. Lastly, their Apple Watch bands. $50 for a rubber strap, all the way up to $450 for a stainless steel link bracelet. I can't even imagine the profit margin on those accessories. Now, that's not to say these products aren't good quality, they just have insanely high markups. And when it comes to the Pro Display XDR stand and VESA mount, Apple considers them to be accessories, and therefore applies the same markups that we've seen in the past. Again, I'm not trying to justify Apple's high accessory prices, I'm just pointing out that this is how Apple has been doing business for decades, and it's likely why the stand is so overpriced. There's also a second point I want to make. As we learned before, Apple is marketing this display to the pro market, and that means they're more likely to have business customers who are inherently less price sensitive than individual consumers. They won't hesitate to spend $1,000 more on a stand or $200 more on a VESA mount if that's what their employees need. But to be honest, I think this display stand fiasco was a huge marketing mistake. Apple should have simply charged $6,000 for their display with its stand included. That way they'd not only make more money from each purchase, but they'd avoid all this negative press, which is taking attention away from other incredible technology they've announced. So while charging $1,000 for a stand is obviously excessive, professionals who actually buy the Pro Display XDR will either not need it or probably won't mind spending the extra money for it. Now that we've discussed an expensive product you'll probably never need, let's talk about an affordable service called Squarespace that's a must for anyone with a website. Squarespace allows you to build the best, most beautiful website you can, all without spending tons of money on development, designing, and hosting, and without worrying about patching or installations or any of that complicated stuff. Squarespace is an all-in-one platform with a super easy-to-use drag-and-drop interface that offers thousands of customizable templates. And if you get stuck or don't know what to do next, Squarespace has helpful video tutorials on their YouTube channel and a 24/7 customer support team. Not to mention the powerful SEO, analytics, and marketing features built right into the service. And if you're thinking about running an e-commerce store, Squarespace allows you to create products to display for sale on your website, offers inventory management tools, and automatically generates shipping labels for you to print off. I actually use Squarespace for my own website after trying quite a few different services, and I highly recommend them. So head over to squarespace.com/appleexplained and get 10% off your first purchase. You can find that link in the description. All right, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.